Good morning. Welcome to the Daily Office. I'm Brother Bill, and this is morning prayer for Saturday, July the 6th. It's the seventh week after Pentecost and week seven in the Psalm cycle. Thanks for joining me. Open thy lips, thy mouth shall declare your praise. Alleluia, by the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down, and there we wept. Alleluia. Psalms 137 and 144, and please recite them with me. Alleluia, by the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down, and there we wept when we remembered Zion. On the willows there we hung up our harps, for there our captors asked us for songs, and our tormentors asked for mirth, saying, sing us one of the songs of Zion. How could we sing the Lord's song in a foreign land? If I forget you, O Jerusalem, let my right hand wither. Let my tongue cling to the roof of my mouth if I do not remember you, if I do not set Jerusalem above my highest joy. Remember, O God, against the Edomites, the day of Jerusalem's fall, how they said, tear it down, down to its foundations. O daughter Babylon, you devastator, happy shall they be who pay you back what you have done to us. Happy shall they be who take your little ones and dash them against the rock. Alleluia. Blessed be God Most High, my rock, who trains my hands for war and my fingers for battle. My rock and my fortress, my stronghold and my deliverer, my shield in whom I take refuge, who subdues the peoples under me. O God, what are humans that you regard them, or mortals that you think of them? They are like a breath. Their days are like a passing shadow. Bow your heavens, O God, and come down. Touch the mountains so they smoke. Make the lightning flash and scatter them. Send out your arrows and rout them. Stretch out your hand from on high and set me free and rescue me from the mighty waters, from the hand of foreigners, whose mouths speak lies, whose right hands are false. I will sing a new song to you, O God. Upon the 10-stringed harp I will play to you, the one who gives victory to kings, who rescues his servant David. Rescue me from the cruel sword, and deliver me from the hands of aliens, whose mouths speak lies, and whose right hands are false. May our sons in their youth be like plants full grown, and our daughters like corner pillars cut for the building of a palace. May our barns be filled with produce of every kind, and may our sheep increase by thousands, by tens of thousands in our fields. And may our cattle be heavy with young. May there be no breach in the walls, no exile, and no cry of distress in our streets. Happy are the people to whom such blessings fall. Happy are the people whose God is the Most High. Alleluia. Glory to you, source of all being, eternal Word and Holy Spirit, as in the beginning, so now and forever. Amen. Alleluia. Alleluia, by the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down, and there we wept. Alleluia. The Holy Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 22, beginning at verse 23. Now the same day some Sadducees came to Jesus, saying, there is no resurrection, and they asked him a question. Teacher, Moses said, if a man dies childless, his brother shall marry the widow and raise up children for his brother. Now there were seven brothers among us. The first married and died childless, leaving the widow to his brother. The second did the same, and so also the third, down to the seventh. Last of all, the woman herself died. In the resurrection, then, whose wife of the seven will she be? For all of them had married her. Jesus answered them, you are wrong, because you know neither the scriptures nor the power of God. For in the resurrection, people neither marry nor are given in marriage, but are like angels of God in heaven. As for the resurrection of the dead, have you not read what was said to you by God? I am the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob. He is God not of the dead, but of the living. And when the crowd heard it, they were astounded at his teaching. When the Pharisees heard that he had silenced the Sadducees, they gathered together, and one of them, an expert in the law, asked him a question to test him. "Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest?" And he said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and first commandment. And a second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." Here ends the lesson. Now let us pray for the church and the world, for the mission of the church, that it may extend the peace and the love of Christ to all people. For Michael, our presiding bishop, for Jennifer Ann, our bishop, for Brother Joe, our community servant, for all of our church leaders, for all clergy and ministers, that they may be ever faithful servants of word and sacrament. For unity in the church, that our scandalous divisions may be healed. For the poor, for the hungry and the thirsty, and for the destitute and the unemployed, that we may share with them the riches of creation and free the world of poverty and famine. For Joe, our president, for Katie, our governor, and for all the leaders of this nation, city, and state, for the leaders of the nations of the world, that they may bring justice and peace in all the earth. That God, who's begun this ministry, may bring it to fulfillment. For all who've died, especially Louise, Brother John David, Brother Richard Bradley, for all the victims of terrorism and violence, and for all who serve in harm's way. For those who are sick, for the aged and the infirm, especially those suffering with dementia, and for Bill and for all those struggling with addiction. For the resolve of the nations to address the climate change crises. For the Mercy of God community, Brother Joe, Brother Tom, Brother Todd, Brother Richard, Brother Bill, Brother Max, Brother Bill, and all of the Mercy of God associates. Rejoicing in the fellowship of Francis and Claire and all the saints, let us commend one another and all of our lives to Christ our God. For the intentions of those who've asked our prayers, and for all of your intentions. Our beloved, which art in heaven, holy is your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us as we forgive others. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Your blessings fill us with joy, Almighty God, for you give us the victory and set us free from the enemy. Accept this, our humble praise and song. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We trust in the mercy of God forever. And glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to God from generation to generation in the church and in Christ Jesus, now and forever. Amen. Hallelujah.